think for my office, the thing I miss the most is my team. You know, I'm very used to having my team around me. There's always a lot of noise, a lot of excitement, people walking in and out. And that was something I was really used to. I am seeing my team almost on a daily basis on Zoom calls now, but it's not the same. So I think it's the team that I miss the most. One thing that I'm really be able to give time now to is taking care of my health. I'm able to work out for at least 1 to 2 hours every day. And this is something, you know, I'm really enjoying because I'm feeling really good about myself. And earlier, this was something I almost always compromised on. So I think giving myself some time for health. That is definitely spending more time with my daughter. My daughter turned 2 earlier this year. And, you know, before I would see her for maybe an hour in a day or a little more if I was lucky. But now that I'm working from home, during this time, I spend time with her in the morning and in the evening. And I'm really able to see her grow up. So that's definitely the best part of K-Mo. Well, I'm not really an early morning person. So I usually start my day off at 8. I have breakfast with my family, and then post breakfast, you know, work tends to start at 9. So usually 9 to 5 is usually how the work day now. Involves a lot of Zoom calls, a lot of meeting with different departments, a lot of interview meeting with management on strategy and things like that. 5 p.m. is a hard stop on work. 5 to 7 is time for exercise. I like to either play badminton downstairs, or we have a small gym in the house, or I walk within the colony. Also, I tend to play with my daughter. We spend some good quality time together. 8 is again dinner time with the entire family around the table. One of the positives of this lockdown again. And post that, you know, it's either playing board games with the family, cards. Nowadays, we've been playing a lot of games over Zoom with friends and family as well. And that's pretty much what my day sounds like every day. Well, I think you know, webinars are the flavor of this lockdown. So I've been spending a lot of time watching and being part of webinars, especially those related to the automotive industry, and also some others on general management strategy and motivational talks. So I've been spending a lot of my time attending webinars. Well, you know what? I think this lockdown has clearly showcased to me that, you know, work from home is possible across industries, especially in the auto industry. You know, earlier I used to think work from home is for IT only. But I think, you know, I see work from home in a different perspective now. You know, the immediate benefits are obviously the time you save on travel. I think that's just a boon, not having to deal with all the traffic. And, you know, all the extra times allows you to spend time with family, do your workout, spend time doing other things that you could not find time for. Also, I think, you know, it really shows that the world is flat, and this allows you to recruit good manpower from anywhere possible. Geography is no longer a restriction. So, you know, many benefits of work from home have become apparent to me. I think for sure, you know, usually on the general course of business, the teams are so busy with everyday operations, sales, service, customer concerns, rides, product quality, etc., etc., that we don't really, you know, sit back, have a look at the bigger picture, the micro environment. Like you mentioned, you know, spot your weaknesses and things like that. But this lockdown has really given us the time to sit back and strategize. I think, you know, we've with all the teams, we've been able to rethink on our entire business and how we go about it. And, you know, a lot of planning has been done on multiple scenarios going forward. And, you know, for sure, I think we have been able to plan strategies to plug some of our weaknesses. You know, like I mentioned, there are many benefits to work from home, which has become more evident to me now. At the same time, I believe there are many advantages of working out of an office, because it allows a physical connection between employees, which is very important for an emotional brand such as ours. You know, but having said that, I definitely feel that work from home would take a larger percentage of our working style moving forward than it has in the past. And I would definitely recommend it to my teams to try it out as well in the longer run. I think I'm already quite lucky to have a self-motivated team. You know, I try my best to stay out of their way while they're doing their job. But I'm also around, and the team knows that they can reach out to me on any topic, big or small. And I think by allowing my team to do what they're good at, they tend to stay motivated themselves. Well, we have done considerable planning over the last few weeks, also on how on restarting operations. We are equipped to restart within, say, 2 to 3 weeks from when the lockdown ends. However, you know, we must remember that we operate in a B2C environment, and what is really important is the time it will take for customer sentiment, confidence, and the buying decision to come back into the market. And that's when we will really be getting back to normal conditions as an industry. Well, I don't think the lockdown in particular has affected the transition to BS6. Yes, there was some lack of clarity for auto dealers with respect to BS4 registrations towards the end of March. However, as brand Benelli, we were able to liquidate all our BS4 stock in time. And we're also well prepared to start introducing BS6 products in a phased manner post the lockdown ends. Well, we are making use of this period to strengthen our processes, upgrade our IT systems, ERPs. We are investing a lot of time in training. Each of the departments is looking into what they need to do to ensure that they are equipped to handle increased sales and increased businesses once we open post the lockdown. We are quite young as a company in the automotive space. We in fact had a very good growth momentum, which was halted by COVID-19. However, we have been using this time to strengthen our basics, and the team is prepared for the next stage of growth after we reopen. As an immediate measure, we have defined post-lockdown SOPs that outline the precautions that not only we will be taking at a plant level, but also will be followed by all our dealers across the country, basically to ensure the safety and hygienic conditions for our customers when they come in either to buy a new product or to service their existing Benelli. On a long term, our focus has always been customers, the riding community, and the product quality, and I think these three will continue to be the pillars of our strategy going ahead. You know, the current focus of the government has been on limiting the spread of COVID-19. While I understand this move from a health perspective, this has left many people and businesses in a very difficult situation simply because of lack of any economic activity. In the next phase, I hope the government takes measures that will directly support economic and business growth, and it will allow the economy to move back towards normalcy.